Hello friends, I am Mrs. Sampada Kulkarni. Welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Today I am going to teach you how to convert the expression from infix form to prefix form using stack data structure. Content of today's session are, I'll focus on application of stack in which the infix to prefix expression conversion and examples of the same. Objectives of today's session are, at the end of this session, every learner will be able to understand how to convert the expression from infix form to prefix form. Before going to the representation of expression, I have already explained what is stack data structure and what are different applications of stack in my previous video session. Please go through that for the details of stack data structure as well as different applications of the stack. Again, I have already explained the expression conversion from infix to postfix form. Now let's see, there are different ways of the representation of expression. Expression can be represented in three ways: the infix expression, postfix expression and prefix expression. The way of representation of the expression, as far as infix expression is concerned, the operator will belong in between of two operands. That's why this is the expression called as infix expression. The postfix expression, where the operator will be after both the operand, that's why the name is given postfix expression. And similarly, with prefix expression, the operator will belong just before both the operand, that's why the name prefix expression. Here, two separate examples are given. If the example or the expression A plus B star C, how it can be represented if we need to represent it with postfix expression as well as prefix expression. The another example is bracket A plus B and then multiply by with C. The same expression represented in postfix form and prefix form. Compiler internally uses the postfix expression and prefix expression for its evaluation. That's why we will study over here how to convert them from infix to postfix form and infix to prefix form. As I have explained previously, infix to postfix form, please refer my video lecture infix to postfix expression conversion. And in today's session, I'll explain how to convert the infix expression into its prefix form. Now let's start with the expression conversion. These are two ways in which we can convert the expression. While conversion of expression will make use of the stack, as this is nothing but the application of stack itself. Now here, stack is used to store the operators, while conversion from infix to any either form, that is postfix or prefix form. So now we'll focus on infix to prefix expression conversion. For that, we need a precedence table. So now let's look at the precedence table, where different operators, all these are the binary operators, with their precedence are given. The exponent operator having highest precedence, multiplication, division and modulo operator is having moderate precedence, addition and subtraction are having low precedence. Now let's see the steps what we need to follow for expression conversion. While conversion of expression from infix to prefix form, the step one is we need to reverse the infix expression, then replace all opening bracket by closing and closing by opening bracket. If operand is can, copy as it is onto the postfix string as now. We are going to find out the postfix expression of the reversed infix string. If operator is can, follow the rules. We have already gone through the rules for expression conversion for infix to postfix form. Somehow they are same, only slight differences between the expression or the rules which we need to follow for expression conversion from infix to prefix form, that I'll explain in the next slide. And next step is perform all above steps repeatedly till end of the reversed infix string. As we have done with the reverse infix string, we'll get the output in postfix expression form. To get the prefix output as we have required, we need to reverse it again, and that will be your final output. Now let's take a glance at the rules for infix to prefix conversion. First rule is just same as of the previous one, that is infix to postfix form. If the stack is empty and if scan character is operator, perform push operation on the stack. If scan operator is opening bracket, directly push it onto the stack. If scan operator is closing bracket, perform pop operation repeatedly till the popped next operator will be the opening bracket. Do not copy brackets in postfix expression, as postfix and prefix expression both are bracket free expressions. Next rule, if the precedence of the operator from infix string is greater than the precedence of the operator which is on top of the stack, then perform push operation. If the operator from infix string is having smaller precedence, then perform pop operation from the stack. And now till 5, all the rules were same for the expression conversion from infix to postfix, but the rule number 6 is only different. If the operator from infix string and the top of the stack are having same precedence, then instead of popping the operator from the stack, perform push operation onto the stack. Means keep the top of the stack as it is and perform push operation onto the stack by pushing the operator from infix string. This only the difference while conversion of infix to prefix expression. At the end, if infix string is finished, pop all the operators till stack will become empty and copy them to postfix string. Now take a glance with the operations or the rules which we are going to follow. If operator in infix string having greater precedence than top of the stack, perform push operation. If operator in infix string having less precedence than top of the stack, perform pop operation. And if they are having equal precedence, then push operator from infix string to the stack. Let's see first example where infix expression is given. We'll find out the reverse of infix expression will look like this, and we'll replace all opening bracket by closing and a vice versa, and your expression will be in this form: f minus e exponent d divide c plus b multiplied by a. Now let's start the conversion and we'll apply a rule. Initially your input expression and your stack and postfix expression are empty. Now let's see f was the operand. It is copied into the postfix expression. Next, minus operator, push it onto the stack. Stack was empty, directly push it onto the stack. Opening bracket, push it onto the stack. E into postfix expression. Exponent operator, push it onto the stack. D on the postfix expression. Closing bracket means perform repeatedly pop operation till opening bracket. It is only the single operator available with the stack. Pop it from a stack and put onto the postfix expression. Next operator is division operator. Division having higher precedence than top of the stack. That's why perform push operation. Opening bracket, push it onto the stack. C, put it onto the postfix expression. Next one is plus operator, push it onto the stack. B, put it onto the postfix expression. Multiply operator having greater precedence than top of the stack. We need to perform push operation onto the stack. Next is A operand, put it onto the postfix expression. Closing bracket, we need to pop till opening bracket. That's why multiply and plus, put it onto the stack. Then we have done with the input expression. That's why empty the stack by performing pop operation. And at the end, the postfix string will be FED exponent CBA multiply plus divide minus. We need to perform again the operation like we need to reverse the string to get the result in prefix expression, and now at the end the result is nothing but minus divide plus star ABC exponent DEF. Now let's see another example where infix expression is given. We are going to find out its reverse infix expression. We are going to replace all opening by closing bracket and vice versa. And now this is the string which we are going to take as input. Now here again the input expression is given. Initially stack and postfix expression both are empty. First F operand, put it onto the postfix expression. Minus operator, push it onto the stack. Opening bracket, push onto the stack. E, put onto the postfix expression. Exponent operator, push onto the stack. D operand on postfix expression. Closing curly bracket, perform pop operation till the opening bracket. Division operator having greater precedence than top of the stack, that way push onto the stack. Opening bracket, push. C, put on postfix expression. Plus operator onto the stack. B in postfix expression. Now minus operator. Now let's see the minus operator, which is from infix expression, having equal precedence than to the top of the stack. Now here, instead of perform pop operation, just same as of the infix to postfix expression conversion, here we are converting it from infix to prefix form. That's why we need to push the operator from infix string to the stack. That is, after performing the operation, both who are having equal precedence are into the stack. Next, A will be in postfix expression. The closing bracket is there. We need to perform consistent pop operation till opening bracket. That's why minus plus are pop from the stack. And now divide and minus operator are also pop from a stack because we have done with the input expression. And here we have done with the infix to prefix expression conversion. Initially it was the infix expression. After applying the rules, we were getting the postfix expression, and after reversing it, this will be the final output as the prefix expression. Thank you dear friends for listening this video. If you like the content and the video, please like the video and subscribe the channel. Thank you and stay tuned.